Compatibility isn't just you're the same as the other person. It really is what fits into what to make your life easier. You're keeping secrets on your pillow. My recommendation is if you have to have a prenuptial, you shouldn't be getting married.
Next to every great man is a great woman.
Men and women operate differently, but they have to find that common ground, that place in between where they can make sure that their own personal agenda doesn't get in the way of what they're giving to their partner. My upcoming book, Parent Coach, is really about coming up with a model over the years of working with parents about what it really means to raise a child today.
The natural expression of ourselves starts with how we see the world around us, not just the larger world, as the lady said in the back.
You know, a lot of people who go on dates lie about their financial situation because they want to impress the person that they're with. Tell me how that's going to work 6 months later when you're more involved in the relationship and it's actually a relationship instead of what I call a pre-relationship. That's the relationship before the relationship when you're really getting to know somebody. Money is a huge issue. Compatibility with money is a huge issue. If you're a person who has a budget, you've got it on Quicken, you've got it all set up, you live within your means, you're not going to do really well with somebody who gets their paycheck, cashes it at the end of the week, and rock and rolls until the next time they get paid. Athletes who become so powerful with success often feel that they are powerful enough to be entitled to whatever they want to do. There's no real consequence to them for their actions. And so we have examples of that. We have Tiger Woods and Kobe Bryant and some of the others. One of the things that I do with my athletes is we work on balance. A balance in one's life. Living with integrity off the field brings a higher level of performance on the field for a longer period of time. Procreating and the desire to procreate after one loses a child is a very, very common feeling. John Travolta and Kelly Preston lost their son. And in that process of losing their son and the grief of that, something was broken for the two of them. And for them, whether or not we agree with what they're doing, whether or not their age is a factor, their religion is a factor. What they're trying to do is they're trying to fill a void that's been created by the loss of their son. The real problem is that this beautiful new child they're going to have is wonderful, but nothing fixes what's been broken. We have a 55% divorce rate in our country. There's 20 million people every day on some online dating site, and they have less than a 10% success rate. I would not say that polygamists have love relationships on a deep level where people are in love. I think it's an arrangement. What's fascinating about Sister Wives or Big Love or any of those shows is watch the relationship between the women, because I think that's where you find the love. I spent much of my childhood in a body cast, actually. I have scoliosis. My spine is kind of shaped oddly like an S and caused a lot of physical pain, which I've had my whole life. But when you're in a body cast from ages 7 to 12, you do a lot of observing of people because you can't really participate. And I think that really opened up my sort of journey and exploration to trying to figure out pain and how people are in pain and the things that go on for them. There is a really growing epidemic in our country, and that is we are raising children without consciences. We're raising kids not to care about integrity, and that's become out of control. The truth of that is that there are ways to train yourself to parent different than the way we were parented in order for you to actually create a family culture, to model and coach a lifestyle where you build the self-esteem, you build the self-character in your child, allowing them to experience their moment, experience their lives. When you know yourself well and you have filled out these evaluations and now you want to put it into practice, you have to live the truth of your answers. People lie on those exams. When we were doing this in my office with the compatibility assessment, I would say 50% of the people I have go back and take it again. Because when you start asking questions, they are putting down answers based on what they think that other person wants to hear, rather than the truth of who they are. And so what we do is we ask them to go out and live these answers. Don't abandon what I call your standards, your criteria of who you are. It took me 40-something years to find my soulmate, the love of my life. I convinced her to let me call her, and she gave me her number, and we talked on the phone, and we talked for about a month and a half, so we got to know each other. That's the value of that if you do it right. We became really good friends, and we found that our view of the world is so similar. I am living the greatest love story I think ever told. There's a still in the street.